Before we jump into intra-domain routing, let's take a look at what a topology might look like inside a single autonomous system. A topology inside an AS consists of nodes and edges that connect them. The nodes are sometimes called points of presence, or POPs. A POP is typically located in a dense population center so that it can be close to the POPs of other providers for easier interconnection, and also close to other customers for cheaper backhaul to customers that may be purchasing connectivity from this particular AS. The edges between POPs are typically constrained by the location of fiber paths, which, for the sake of convenience, typically parallel major transportation routes, such as railroads and highways. Here's an example of a single AS topology, which is the Abilene Network, which is a research network in the United States. Each of these locations would be considered a POP, and each of these POPs may have one or more edges between them. Georgia Tech is an autonomous system that connects at the Atlanta POP of the Abilene Network. Here's a close-up of the Abilene Network in the southeastern U.S. The Abilene Network connects to other universities in the southeast near Atlanta at an internet exchange point called SOX, or Southern Crossroads. Now, thus far, we've just talked about the topology of an autonomous system, which essentially defines the graph. The next step is to compute paths over that topology, a process called routing. Routing is the process by which nodes discover where to forward traffic so that it reaches a certain node. There are two types of intra-domain routing. One is called distance vector, and the other is called link state. In the rest of this lesson, we'll explore the two different types of intra-domain routing and the advantages and disadvantages of each of them. Let's first take a look at distance vector routing.